Hello, and thank you for joining us for this segment of Daily Bible Bites at Mount Olive Multicultural Community Church. Today we are in chapters 3 and 4 of the book of Deuteronomy. Next, we turn toward King Og's land of Bashan. He mobilized his army and attacked us at Edrei. All his people and his land are yours, the Lord told me. So the Lord helped us fight, and we conquered all cities. We utterly destroyed the kingdom of Bashan, but we kept the cattle and loot. We now possessed all the land from the valley of Arnon to Mount Hermon. Incidentally, King Og was the last of the giant Rephaim. His iron bedstead measures 13 and a half feet long by 6 feet wide. I gave the conquered land to the tribes of Reuben, Gad, and the half-tribe of Manasseh. I reminded the tribes of Reuben and Gad and the half-tribe of Manasseh that although the Lord had given them the land, they could not begin settling down until their armed men led the other tribes across the Jordan to the land the Lord was giving them. Then I said to Joshua, "You have seen what the Lord has done to these two kings. You will do the same to all the kingdoms on the other side of the Jordan." I made this plea to God, "O Lord God, please let me cross over into the promised land." But the Lord was angry with me because of you. "Speak of it no more," he ordered, "but go to the top of Mount Pisgah where you can see the land. Commission Joshua to replace you, for he shall lead the people across." Chapter 4. And now, Israel, listen carefully to these laws and obey them if you want to possess the land. Do not add the other laws or subtract from these. When the surrounding nations hear the laws, they will exclaim, "What other nation is as wise and as prudent as Israel?" Be very careful never to forget what you have seen God doing for you. Tell your children about the glorious miracles he did. Tell them about the day you stood before the Lord in Mount Horeb, and he told me, "Summon the people. I will instruct them. You stood at the foot of the mountain, and the mountain burned with fire. And the Lord spoke from the fire. He proclaimed the Ten Commandments and wrote them on two stone tablets. But beware, you didn't see the form of God. So you don't defile yourselves by trying to make a statue of God. And do not worship the sun, moon, or stars. The Lord has rescued you to be his special people. Beware lest you break the contract. He is devouring fire, a jealous God. In the future, when you have been in the land a long time and you have defiled yourselves by making idols, you shall be quickly destroyed. Soon now you will conquer that land, but your days there will be brief. For the Lord will scatter you, and you will be but few in number. There, far away, you will worship idols, but you will also begin to search again for Yahweh, and you shall find him, and you search for him with all your hearts. You will finally return to the Lord and listen to what he tells you, for the Lord your God is merciful. In all history, search to see if you can find anything like this. Where else will you ever find another example of God removing a nation from its slavery? Yet that is what the Lord did for you. He let you hear his voice, and he let you see his great pillar of fire. You even heard his words. It was because he loved your ancestors that he personally brought you out from Egypt. Yahweh is God, and there is no God other than him. You must obey these laws that I will tell you today. Then Moses instructed the people to set apart three cities where anyone who accidentally killed someone could flee for safety. So today, it's just kind of plain what's going on here. God told them that they would conquer, and they did. God is telling you today that you will conquer. You have conquered already, even though you may be just waiting for the manifestation of it. Make sure that you are following his commandments for you. Let him speak to you directly. He's given us his word. We know what we're to do here, but he has a special job for you to do. So listen to him. Let him know, "Yes, Lord, I hear you. Yes, Lord, I will obey." And then do it. Just do it. There's a message that is on here that my husband gave a few weeks ago. Just do it. I'll put it up at the top, as a matter of fact. But that's what we have to do. We don't wait. We don't tarry. Do what God tells us to do right then. Conquer the land. He's with you. Conquer every challenge that goes in front of you, any enemy that is coming for you. God has positioned you to win. Don't serve other gods. Don't put other gods before him. And this is not like the old idols and things like that, but we can make work our God. We can make other people our gods. We can make a husband, a wife, our children, our gods. Don't put anyone or anything before the Lord God. The true and living God is Yahweh. follow him, honor him, worship him, and do what he commands you to do so that you can inhabit the land and all that is therein, and then you can tell someone else about it. Tell them about it. Give a testimony about it, but don't give other people credit for it, because you don't want other men, not even yourself, to boast. Tell of the goodness of the Lord God and win other souls to him. Thank you so much for joining us for this segment of Daily Bible Bites. Join us back again where we'll continue in chapter 5 of the book of Deuteronomy. God bless you, and we hope to see you on the other side at www.dltmoreministries.com for our church services, Bible studies, prayer meetings, and small groups. God bless you, and we love you in Jesus' name. Bye-bye.